Hi, this is Dr. K. Sweetser from San Diego State University, and I'm going to show you the process that I use when I am trying to figure out intercoder reliability for a media assessment or content analysis project that I'm working on. So I have a Google form that I have used as my code sheet. I have trained all of my coders and I have my coding now underway. I like to do my intercoder reliability pretty early on in the coding process, just so that when there are errors, I can report them back to the coder and I can then help the coder get closer to what was actually expected via the code sheet and the code book. So here is a Google spreadsheet of the export of all of the items that have been coded so far. Now, in order to check intercoder reliability, you're going to need, of course, coders, but you also need one coder that is essentially going to be like the law of the land, the ruling coder that basically understands the coding categories and whatever that person says. That a particular category needs to be coded that way, that is actually how it is intended to be coded. So this is, if you think of it a lot like a quiz or an exam, it's almost like the key to the exam. It's the correct answers to each of the items. So I take an item that has been coded by a coder, and I would highlight it and I would copy it to my clipboard, and then I would go over into a brand new tab where I am just checking, or quote, grading each coder's work. And so if I scroll all the way to the end, you can see that I'm going to be grading the work of this coder here. And then ICR is just the acronym that I use that stands for intercoder reliability. And so the bottom line here is of the correct answers. Again, here's a coder's work, and then the bottom line is the correct answers. Here's a coder's work, and the bottom line is the correct answers. And so in between each of these bands of yellow are the exact same article. So the coder coded over in the other sheet, I copied it over, the coder coded all of the items for or all of the categories for this particular item. And then I probably had the ICR person code it in there as well. And then I just deleted it from the actual database so that there were not two versions of them. But I've pulled them over into a clean place where I can stack them up, one on top of each other. And then I can easily scroll over. I'm gonna be looking at these two. To start with, I can easily scroll over and I can look for, are there times when the coders disagreed? And then I highlighted it red. So the top line is the coder, the bottom line is the correct or the answer key from the ICR coding. And so I can see that this person said that this category was absent, but in fact, the key, the main coder said, no, this was supposed to be present. So I would actually follow up with, probably in an email, with my coder, and I would paste the ID number and the link to the article that they had coded. And then I would say very clearly, you marked this category, and then I would state the category here as being absent. It was actually present. And then I would go into the article and I would pull the phrase that sort of triggered that this actually should have been marked present, so that the coder can learn from that and see it in the articles that that coder has actually looked at. And then sometimes I'll also paste verbiage from the actual code book. So I'm going to continue on to look. Okay, so here we have another one. This time the coder said it was present, but it actually should have been absent. So I would provide feedback to that as well. This time again, it was absent, but it should have been present. and so on and so forth. So I then found in this particular one, we had 1, 2, 3 errors. Now I have to find out what is the score going to be for this. So I have to count up how many of these different categories there were. And I probably should have done that before the video started, but let's go ahead and try. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 53. Okay, so there are 53 items on here. Thank God that this was not one that had hundreds of items on here. So they missed 3 out of 53. So I would go ahead and I would figure out on my little calculator if they got 50 correct out of 53, then that's going to be a 94% agreement using Holsti's formula for the percentage of agreement, and that is an intercoder reliability formula. Let's look at the next person. So the next person actually got a pretty important variable incorrect. So that was one variable that was incorrect. There was another present absent item that the person got incorrect. They didn't paste the quote like they were supposed to in there. They got another present absent in there incorrect. What am I up to on this one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so there were 6 incorrect there, right? So I go back to my calculator, and if there are 53 items on the code sheet and they got 6 incorrect, then they got 47 correct. So 47 divided by 53, they have an 88% intercoder reliability, which is still good. It's still fine. Now, in my actual coded items, for these ones that I have determined that this was input incorrectly, I am going to go back into my cleaned data and where my actual analysis is. I'm going to make sure that I don't have the same article twice. So if the ICR coder is in here, I'm going to delete out the ICR coder items out of this one. And for the person whose coding I was checking, I'm actually going to correct the inaccuracies of what they had coded that I found in the coding process. So you're only taking about a 10% of the overall coded items in here for checking each of your coders. And if I were trying to do this entire project, then I would, you know, look at overall, what were my scores? And so I know that one of my scores was 50 out of 53. Another one was 47 out of 53. And then I would add, I would figure up what all of my ICR individual scores were for my individual articles. And I would take an average of that to create that overall project intercoder reliability. I can do the same thing with a variable. So like, look at this variable right here. I see that every single time this variable is coded, that the coders get it wrong, right? And so this actually signals to me that I probably need a better description of this variable and what triggers this variable in the code book. But if I was asked to report the ICR just for one of the categories, the ICR for this category, based on the fact that I have 3 items so far that I'm checking for ICR, the ICR would be 0. In this particular category, if I were just reporting the ICR for all of my coders, but only on this variable, I see that I have 1 out of the 3 that was done incorrectly. So my ICR would be 66%, which is below reliability. So you can do reliability for the coder, which is going to be the overall or the article and the coder, which is going to be the overall thing that the person coded, And you can further drill down and do ICR just for the particular variable, and that would be the column. But in every case, you're checking what someone coded against a correct, quote, key version of that particular article, which means the article has to have been coded by two different people, right? So you're checking that that percentage of correctness or percentage of agreement, as Holsti calls it. And so that is how you figure out ICR. Happy coding.